can get coffee in bed, you might never leave it. He really does want you to get out and explore the estate. Breakfast and lunch, somewhat informal, sort of buffet stuff. Dinner, the most formal meal of the day. Mr. Hearst sits in the center of the table. Across from him in the early years would have been his wife, Millicent. He married a woman named Millicent Veronica Wilson in 1903. They would have five sons together by 1950. That same year, he starts a relationship with the actress Marion Davies. That relationship will last the rest of his life. Christmas time, 1925. Mr. and Mrs. Hearst separate. We'll never be divorced. She spends more and more time on the East Coast. She has a large home there on Sands Point, Long Island. She never really liked this place much anyway. She lived at that dusty old ranch in California. She likes to travel on East Coast high society circuits. And of course, would make that very difficult for her to continue to do that. So after 1925, across from Mr. Hearst, most often the actress Marion Davies. Unless, of course, Julie Morton would be with her. Then she'd be seated across from him. One of her business associates, Manny Walter Stauber, called the evening where they were drawing on these paper napkins. New plans and ideas for the estate. He said he could see the lightning bolts bouncing between their skulls. He said that Mr. Hearst and Miss Morgan were together, everyone else was 500 miles away. When you first arrived, you find a little name card with your name on it. But as the nights wore on, you find your name bouncing down the table. Kind of a discreet way of saying by the time you got to the end, by the time you packed your bags, so home. But if you play by the rules up here, likely you would be invited back. The actor Cary Grant was a guest here nearly 40 times. Mr. Hearst and Miss Morgan would see this room as being Gothic, style and drama. Gothic architecture really seeks to draw the eye heavenly. And they often do that through the use of a pointed arch. It's called an OG arch. It simulates hands clasped in prayer. And they're all over this room. These are more briar souls. These ones are Spanish, they're from the 15th century. There's that pointed arch. It's a French Gothic mantle. The arch is there. It's also above all the windows. Initially, Mr. Hearst wants stained glass for these windows. He gets what he likes and wants. He's not happy. He says it's too dark. They pull out the stained glass, they put up the clear glass, he's happy with the effect. He says, what can be better than the blue skies today? And the inquisitive stars at night peeking in to see all the rackets. He loves country western music. Some nights a country band sets up in the corner. The sons of the pioneers came up, they played Total Indian.